The pain on their faces told it all. Such young souls gone forever, their dreams and aspirations shattered in a split second following the grisly road accident. Kenyatta University continues to mourn the death of their students, and they were here in their numbers to pay their last respects to two of the students, Mary Minor and Vina Isoe, both Bachelor of Arts Education students. Vina's uncle, John Masharia, relieved at the moment when the family received the shocking news informing him of his niece's passing.
Moment for us. We request that you be with us with prayers.
The news reached them while they were attending the burial ceremony of one of their nephews. One of the students will be buried on Tuesday next week in Kisii. The other will be laid to rest on Thursday in Nyahururu. The university management called on the students to be more cautious and also recognize their value to their family, society and the nation.
University, we stand by you in this trying time and assure you that we shall give you the support that we usually extend to families of those who pass on while they are students in Kenyatta University.
And as they mourned in Nairobi over the deaths in Kisii, these were the scenes on the roads. Police officers, perhaps spurred into action by the death of the 8 students, launched a massive crackdown for defective vehicles. 42 vehicles were defective and unroadworthy, with some found to have tampered with the speed governors. 17 passengers who did not use seatbelts were also arrested. County Police Commander Agnes Elihabi Mudamba cautioned those operating non-designated PSVs the risk prosecution, calling for caution on the roads.
Officers from NTSA, they normally write or they can authorize such people to be, their licenses to be withdrawn. People from the NTSA have authority to do that for those serial offenders.
Caroline Kamara reporting for Channel 1.